welcome back to the show. I always love it when you come on. Thank you for coming on. You were telling me backstage that how much you love New York City.
Yeah.
This time of year. You do.
I do. I said I have a home here, but I haven't been here. I go back and forth, but I'm in L.A. now most of the time.
Yeah.
When you get here, I come back and I'm like a tourist. It's funny, look at all the buildings.
it is kind of amazing.
You don't even understand until you get away from New York how special all of you are, that you live in this combined area and everybody's impolite at the same level. Don't look at each other. When you do ask something, everybody's pleasant. The best food, everywhere, even street food, everything is better than every place else I've ever been.
New York, everything.
We go to... I take my family to the Rockettes, and if you were to explain the Rockettes to just a pedestrian person any place else, it's scantily clad women, high-kicking, and then they show Jesus.
This is an odd way to describe it.
Well, you go, that's not canceled?
Fascinating. How amazing are the Rockettes?
They're so amazing that, it's just so amazing.
I love the toy soldier.
The toy soldier's falling down, and the people singing. Everything about it's just New York. You just
got to
really appreciate where you live. You people are amazing.
How are you going to spend Thanksgiving?
Go to Detroit.
Oh, you're fantastic.
Well, look, there is that.
I love this city enough. I'm tired of moving on.
I want to move on. My family's from Detroit. Move back. We meet it around my mom, who's aging, and there's a lot of us, and we go to the Lions game. I'm a Detroit Lions fan.
That's right.
Weird year this year, and also a Giants fan. And also an Eagles fan, which is weird. Yep. So it's one of those deals. So
back. What do you cook Thanksgiving? What's your favorite?
I cook nothing except put out fires.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, you got some people drink, some people laugh, some people write. A lot of arguing. And you should have never said that.
Oh yeah.
I'm actually over here. It's old recipes. That's what I keep. My family hates food because we're German, Canadian, and Irish, and there's not a cook in those countries. My grandma had a cookbook literally translated from German was just try to keep it down.
That's what it said.
She
try to keep it down. Whatever you make.
And my favorite story then, I had a aunt who, she was into cooking sherry. And there was a big pot of turkey gravy and a big pot of caramel sauce. And by the fifth brandy, she goes, why do we have two pots? And she just poured them and mixed them together. Yep, poured it on ice cream, and you had, 30 kids going, Cut two, that's like a delicacy now, salted caramel.
Thinking, wow. She was ahead of her time.
Way ahead of her time.
I want to mention you're doing, you have these giant stand-up tour dates. There's more going into the new year. They're massive. February 2nd, you're at the Belco Theater in Denver, Colorado. Yeah. February 3rd, you're at the Fox Theater.
Fox Theater in Detroit, yeah.
So it's like kind of a homecoming.
I love it.
When you do stand-up, do people yell out stuff to you?
Yeah, it's like positive heckling. Because I get half and half people go, hey, tool boy, I get that. randomly in some cities, that's all they remember is tool time.
Yeah.
And that's literally a city, too. People screaming out, they don't quite get, hey, hammer boy. Hammer Time. No, that's MC Hammer. That had nothing to do with me.
Hammer Time.
That was the original name of the show.
Was it?
Yeah, Hammer Time, but MC at the same time was doing his
MC
Hammer, so we couldn't use it. But I got a guy up in Sacramento who goes, tool belt! Couldn't quite get the thing down. And there's a vice grip. No.
Did you get Infinity and Beyond?
Yeah.
To infinity.
But that's usually, when I'm in a group of people and adults or kids going, what did that big man swallow Buzz Lightyear for?
They don't quite understand, yeah.
Well, that's why, remember Warner Brothers and Warner Cartoons, they never let the actors ever do the characters outside of the cartoon.
I read that, yeah.
Yeah, because they got, Hank's and I did this once and he taught me a great trip. We did the Children's Hospital sometimes.
Yeah.
And it like freak them out if we start talking like Woody and Buzz. So we did this thing, Tom says, shut your eyes and turn around. And we'd have these kids, and then we'd do a little shtick.
That's a great idea.
But you don't want to see me doing Buzz Lightyear.
That's so cool. That's awesome you do that.
Yeah.
Is there I also read somewhere that you don't have to say if it's true or not, but I would love it if you did. Is there a Toy Story 5?
Oh, hey.
Did you hear that? Because I love the movies. But
one of the original creators of one of the series, and I don't drop his name because Bob Iger, head of Disney, said it was on. He actually said that it was going to happen.
Yeah.
They have reached out to Tom and I to reprise the roles. They're not saying anything about it. What it is for people like me, it's just like I'm a sci-fi buff. And you wonder if four was too many. Is five going to be too much?
No.
And according to the scuttlebutt, the writer that's doing it wrote one of the better ones. And he said, if I didn't get this right, I wouldn't do it. So it could be a very, very interesting way to reunite it.
I would love to see it. I'd love it. You know, they're all great. They're all great. Let's talk about your series, The Santa Clauses. Mm-hmm. On Disney Plus, you did this last year, was it?
That was our first season last year.
And it was the number one show on Disney Plus.
Right.
Congratulations, buddy. Okay. Not too shabby.
Well, again, I don't like doing these unless it answers questions, because I was one of these guys, sci-fi buff, and I go, yeah. I was asked these questions. They said, why did, when Santa slid off the roof in the original movie, what happened to him? Did I kill him? Is he dead?
Yeah.
And then I kept asking in the script, and I show up at the North Pole, and the elves didn't even seem to care.
Yeah.
Just some guy that's not fat. You go, get the gifts out of here. Was there a Mrs. Claus died too?
You ask all these questions.
All these questions that no one cared.
And they're like, no, it's fun. No, Tim, we're having fun.
Well, the original script, actually, it was written by two comedians, and I shot Santa in the original script. I was crying. I was laughing so hard. And at the point, Jeffrey Katzenberg, head of Disney, says, we're going to get you to do the movie. We're going to change a few things. They go, no, no, that's the best script I've ever read. First movie I've ever done, so it
there
wasn't meant.
Out of all the scripts.
They said, we can't begin a Disney movie, Tim, with you murdering Santa Claus.
Please, no.
No, and I said, why not? You kill all the parents in all your other movies, you know. You know. Don't they?
Don't they
shit like Lion King?
Boom, Bambi, absolutely.
They're horrible to their people.
That's so funny. Do you ever slip, though, as, like, if you are, I mean, you're dressed as in the suit. I mean, do you ever slip and say a curse word?
Because I'm not a blue comedian. I drop the F-bomb on stage. So, I mean, I don't talk about weird stuff. It just, I'm a lazy comedian. So,
no, you are not. You're one of the best.
Well, thank you. I was on, it's 4 hours in makeup, and I thought the kids were actors. I wasn't aware early on that they were just kids with rubber ears. So I'd get kind of into it, and then I'd drop the F-bomb every now and then. And then eventually Disney showed up with the suits and briefcases, and, hey, Tim, we got a little request. Could you stop dropping the F-bomb when you're around these kids? And I said, what effing kids? What are you talking about? These are actors.
They're children.
So they took me into a room and they said, you got to stop doing that.
Yeah.
Because we did one kid and another kid were having like, they're twisting each other's nipples, little kid thing. They're going, ow, you step in there. And every time the shot came around, I had to do this and they'd start laughing. And they go, cut, guys. And I go, guys, let's just get through this, can we? And I yelled F so loud that all that killed the kids froze. Because you have Santa Claus fully dressed, screaming. And I had to tell all the kids, they said, tell them something else. So I said, I mispronounced, it's fuke. It's a Swedish word. It means ornament. So
that word?
Yeah. Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Fuke! What is happening in season two of The Santa Clauses?
Oh, this is a different Santa from a way long time ago shows up. As he was turned into a nutcracker because he got a little angry. And he ends up wanting to take the North Pole back. And he's with gnomes, and elves have a little problem with each other. And it's a long story. They're all 900 years old, so a lot of this takes place before us. And it's this lineage to how Santa becomes Santa. And mispronunciations of names, which is funny to me, because his name is Magnus Antus. But when you say it fast, it sounds like Mad Santa. So I love little stupid bits.
Well, I love this.
It's a story. And also, Santa's got two kids. We find out that the first humans ever born at the North Pole. It's a real mystical thing. So the kids are getting to be, I want my son to be Santa, and my daughter wants to be a witch, because there's witches in the North. It's a long story.
No, it's great. It's good, it's funny, and it's for the whole family. I want to show a clip. Here's Tim Allen in season two of The Santa Clauses. Take a look at this.
Let's just move on, okay? Nothing else really big deal, except that we have to do Easter this year from the North Pole.
What? Easter? How do you suppose
Easter?
What is Easter? We don't know nothing about no Easter?
Yeah, like, does the Easter bunny hide the Easter eggs, or do the eggs hide themselves?
Exactly, and what do eggs have to do with Jesus?
How did Jesus like his eggs?
It's true, don't get chickens and bunnies involved in Easter. Rabbits don't lay eggs. Blah, blah, blah. It's a whole TED talk now.
What does Ted the rabbit have to say?
Ted's the chicken. Pay attention, Dad.
Yeah, pay attention, Dad. Tim Allen, everybody, season two of The Santa Clauses is streaming now on Disney+. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around, everybody.